Okay, today we have a puzzle. So I'm going to give you all the numbers from 1 to 15. I suspect you're going to shorten this dramatically in the edit. Your challenge is, can you take the numbers from 1 to 15 and can you rearrange them into a new order such that any two adjacent numbers add to give you a square number? So for example, you could put one, let's give it a go, we'll give it a try. We can put one there, and then next to it we can put three. You go, okay, that's pretty good, because 1 plus 3 is 4, that's a square number. I could chuck 6 here, because 3 plus 6 is 9, that's a square number. Oh, what am I gonna do? What can I add to that to make it a square number? 10, that'll work, right? And then so on, so we'll give you a second if you wanna try it.
So we have to use all of them?
You have to use all of them. In one long line, any order you want, but any two that are adjacent have to add to a square number. Welcome back, thank you for trying the puzzle. If you got it to...
It could be days later.
My goodness, how you have aged. But you know, you gave it a go. You're saying, Brady, you didn't think it was possible. Like, it feels unlikely, you know? But it can be done. And I gave you a false start. It doesn't work if you have these numbers in this order. So I deliberately and very meanly gave you a starting point that does not work.
Why would you do that?
Because I'm a jerk. I want people to work it out for themselves. But why doesn't it work? Right? Because this does, like, this fulfills the requirement. Every two of these do add to give you a square number, but then you can't join up the rest of them, right? You run out of room. So the way I went about solving this when I first did it was I thought, okay, I'm going to draw all the possible links, because you start looking at this and you're like, okay, well, 10 works with 15 because I get 25, but 10 also works with 6. And so actually I've got options for how I put them in the same order. And some of them have more possible links or neighbors they could go with than you can actually put in a long line. So I was like, right, I'm going to do this. There's one. I'm going to put one over here. I can do them in order, that's one. Okay, two, one and two don't add to give you a square number, so I'm gonna put two over there out of the way, right, okay. Three, now three I can add link to one, because that gives me 4. That is a square number. Now, 4 doesn't work with anything so far, but it does work with 5, so put 5 over there. 6 works with 3. And so you can see if I only had the numbers from 1 to 6, it wouldn't be possible to order them. So every single pair adds to a square number. Put 7 into the mix. 7 goes with 2, because that gives you 9. 8 adds on to 1, gives you 9. 9 fits in off 7, because I get 16. 10 links into 6, 16, 11. And still now, I've got these series I could use. In fact, if this looks familiar, that there is the original series I gave. 8, 1, 3, 6, 10 is one possible ordering, but there's no way so far to link it up with the rest of them. We'll keep filling these in. 12, 2, 4, 13 will also link to 12 because I can get 25, but oh, I can also get 16, so that links to, aha! Okay, so now we're starting to join this all together. Let's put in 14, and 14 is the first number where now everything holds together, because 14, 25, and 16, we've now got a connected network, or graph, whatever you want to call it. But there's no path, right? So this would work, but you've missed 1 and 8. That would work, but you've missed these. So at 14, it's all joined together, but it doesn't work. 15 is the one you need to hold it all together, because 15 fills in this gap. So there's 25 and 16, and now there's our solution. 8, 1, 15, 10, 6, 3, 13, 12, and then all the way along that tail. And so that is the order you've got to put those numbers so that every single pair between them adds to a square number. And I picked this bit here of this curve, knowing that that is not a valid part of the path that goes all the way through this square sums network.
That makes 15 pretty special number.
That makes 15 a pretty special number. It's the first number for which you can order the numbers. So every single, so you are right, Brady, to think that doesn't feel likely. And it's because I picked 15, because up until then, it doesn't work. I could have picked 16, actually, because 16, you can add on to 9 to get 25. Okay, Oh, wait, or 17. Okay, so 17 goes over there. And so now you think, oh, there you go, that's perfect. And there's a path, 16 all the way through to 17. You have a perfectly valid solution. But why stop there? Why not do it from 1 to 18? 18 fits in over here. There's 18. Oh, now we've got a problem. Because if we put 18 over there, there's no longer a way to go through the whole network going through every single number once and once only. Because we've got a tail here sticking off and we've got a little tail sticking here. And if we start here and go that way, we can never get back to 18. And if we start here, we can never get back for these guys. So we've broken it. So it works for all the numbers from 15 to 17, and then 18 breaks it. But what if it works again after that? So we'd call this a graph in mathematics, and graph theory is what we're kind of using to solve this puzzle. And we're looking for a path. A path is any kind of journey which doesn't go through the same vertex more than once. And if we have a path that goes through every single vertex, then it's called a Hamiltonian path. And so to solve this puzzle, you're looking for the Hamiltonian path which goes all the way through the graph. So let's try adding on a few more numbers and see if we can get it to work for a bigger value. If I add 19 over here, that doesn't solve our two tails problem over there. So as long as this exists, there are no solutions. 20 doesn't help. Oh, actually, that's now solved one tail problem. So we can come in here. Oh, wait, but if we come in here, we either go around that way or we go around that way, because we then have to come off and do the rest of this. And because of this bottleneck here and here, you do one way, but if you loop around, then you can't get out. So that's still not solvable. We need another way out of this loop before we can do it. 21, oh, starting to get crowded. 21 can go down here because it links 15. Which I'm going to run under there, to 4. So these are crossing, but that's not a new vertex, right? Obviously, I'm just drawing the links. 22 links up 3 to 14. Does that get us out of our problem? Because we can come through here and out, but then we can't get, it's still not doable. It can be done once we get to 23. So if we put 23 in, let's pop it down there. Now, it is possible to trace all the way through this network. Shall we give it a go? I have spoken too soon. Okay, we can work this out. So,
how are we doing?
Okay, let's see if we can do this. We've got to start from 18, because that's like our little tail over here. If we come in here, and we go all the way around here, I suspect we need to mop up these, because if we leave any of these behind, we're gonna be in trouble. So let's come down, take those, get into here, come up here. Oh yeah, here we go. Then we go across 21, 15, 10, 6, 19, 17, 8, 1, and there you go. So it's possible to find a Hamiltonian path on the graph as soon as we add node 23. But very sadly, when we add node 24, it breaks again. So 24 joins 1 to 12. 24 goes there, and then 1 links to 12. And now it's broken again. But when you add 25, it's fixed again. And it then works for 26, it works for 27, and it works all the way up. So we think, as far as we're aware, from 25 onwards, it works for every possible value. You can somehow find a path through this network.
Well, it's not over yet, people. If you'd like to see even bigger graphs with more nodes and their Hamiltonian paths, have a look at our extra footage over on Number File 2. You'll also hear more stories from Matt, including how he made a bit of a Parker Square of this issue when he was doing his book, and you'll hear from a very special guest. I'll put links down in the description and in all the usual places. Thanks for watching.